Buckley. Fantastic.
Yes, teams on 10, week 7, number 7. An important number down in Carlton territory. The Dominator Rats. Dylan Buckley.
Adam Bentick.
Eggs Benedict. So it will be a big show. The issue in my world this week has been captain's hair. And a lot of talk about eccentric behaviour by the Melbourne skipper. We've got a Carlton skipper on today, a mate of yours who was very clean cut.
That's it, mate. Marc Murphy, one of the cleanest cut players I've seen on and off the field. Jeez, he could kick the footy. Can't wait to see him in the tray challenge later, so it'd be good to get him on.
Did he ever have a mohawk?
He used to have your hair cut a while back, so we'll see what he says about that.
Go get him.
Murph, welcome to Channel 10, mate. It's fantastic to have you here. Now, isolation, it's been busy for you. You've been a stay-at-home dad while Jess is at work.
Yeah, she's still working from home, so I've got a bit of help there. But dealing with a very active two-year-old bucker has its challenges, but I've actually really enjoyed it. But pretty happy to be back training a few days a week now.
It is, mate, and you're looking a fantastic-looking dad as well. Mate, big game coming up this week against the D's. The last time Carlton beat Melbourne was when I kicked 3 at the G. So there's a bit of a void there. How are you going to feel it this weekend?
Gee, that was a fair while ago. Did you kick 3, did you?
Three, brought him down.
Other than one game where we got smacked by 100 points, we've actually been in most games against Melbourne over the last 3 years.
Okay.
But it would be nice for someone to club up and kick 3 like a good self. But they're a very good side, I reckon. The D's, they're fighting fit, no doubt, like everyone else is flying at the moment in pre-season. But we're pretty excited to play them first up. It'll be good.
Now, I want to talk about that older sort of players like yourself. I would have been if I could stay on a list. But early days, it was seen for young guys to, you know, if you stepped out of line, the older guys would cut you back in. A young player that I love, he's going to be a superstar, Brody Kemp, with a blonde hair. How do you feel about that?
Yeah, the peroxide hair. Yeah, well, I wouldn't have thought I'd be doing that my first year. I couldn't even get on the physio table for the first 3 years just because I was nervous of the senior blokes getting flat with me. But we like the young guys expressing themselves. Everyone's their own person, so yep. We'd love to see it.
Beautiful, mate. And you always make it well known you're a fantastic junior cricketer. We had Brett DeLiddy on the show a couple of weeks ago. He was talking a little bit off air about he might have been the superior cricketer to yourself. What do you have to say about that?
I played under 17s with Lids, and they formed an AIS squad out of that. I got in that, and Lids didn't. So you tell me who you reckon's better.
What a hit out down to Murphy. Now Murphy on the left boot. From there, it's almost impossible.
Righto, player's call. Now, before we get to it, I reckon you're the only player in the league at the moment that has a banana compilation. You've got a six-minute offering on YouTube. You do like the nani, don't you?
I do like the nana. And T has actually given me a license to have a go at him. I've got to look towards
the
corridor
license.
First. I've got to look towards the corridor first, but if no one's there, then it's a bit of a license. But I've got lucky a couple of times.
Well, one of those games, I'm going to take you back to round 15, I think it was, last year, and deep in the contest against Freo, and the Blues needed someone to stand up, and we'll pick it up now, and it's Cruiser and Big Sean Darcy, and I can hardly see because of the sun, and it gets slapped forward, I think, by Murphy. Look at Big Levi flexing some muscles and flings it over to Fisher. Oh,
the difference, Zach Fisher, he calls himself the difference, but I finish off a little banana, little candy cell, but it wasn't too bad.
Can you talk it up? It was amazing. He's the best banana I've ever seen, and they're mobbing him, and he's a star.
That's bloody right.
Righto, Spray of the Day, my favourite segment, because it takes us back to years gone by, and your first coach, Dennis Pagan, great wordsmith, a strange orator, but good with the one-liners, and he had the note, pee down my back and tell me it's raining in Media Street, and he must have had some weirdness for you back in 06.
Yeah, it was my first coach, Dennis, and I loved him. He was brilliant, had some great one-liners, as you said, but still remembering getting into Luke Livingston.
Number four.
Yeah, smashed into Josh Kennedy, and young Josh Kennedy was a high draft pick, and the guys weren't allowed to touch the high draft picks back then, so he whacked him in a body contest, and it was mock and a half. So mock and a half, I don't know what that actually means, but with mock pressure, I mean, don't actually touch him, but mock and a half, so there you go.
That is effectively, Brumbies can smash each other, and blood on the track, and good players stay away from them.
Yeah, correct, which I don't mind. I think that's okay.
We reckon we can win this game. We reckon we can win it if you blokes stick together. Let's get out there now.
Oh, Righto, boys, sorry to interrupt. It is time for the Triton Trade Challenge. Thanks to Magic Hand Car Wash, 13 locations across Victoria, Murphin. I'm ready for it today with my boot, and I'm expressing myself with my one glove. And have you heard about the Triton Trade Challenge?
I have heard about this. It's good to see you've got a shoe on, or a boot, and a glove, which I'm not sure that's going to help you much, but... Sticky mitts, you reckon?
I'm waving in planes with a glove on. I know how Gorney feels. We better run over the rules, Dylan, and we better sanitise the champion.
We will, mate. Magic Hand Car Wash, fantastic hand sanitiser. Get some, mate. You might need some more. And we've made one kick 30 metres out in the back of the tray. So Mitch Duncan, the only player besides myself to
And do you have the courage to banana it?
I do. It's very slippery at the moment with sanitiser.
Go, Mark.
Oh, clean! Oh, no! He's taken the didn't he?
Is that serious?
Nah. Oh, nice height. Bounce! Oh, a bit of a debris on the ground.
He likes a double hand ball drop.
No, is he a double hander?
No. I'm a guider. I'm a guider.
I'll say that to my two-year-old.
I'm a guider, mate. I guide. Oh, not bad, Butsy!
Oh!
Yeah! Woo! Woo! Well, Murph, gorgeous skills. Just wandered up laconically and went bang. Yeah, you're going to hit round two in fine form.
I thought you were talking about yourself there.
No, I got lucky, mate.
No, let's hope so anyway.
Beautiful. Well, for being a good sport and having a bit of fun, you get a very nice prize. You get a 12-month unlimited wash club membership with Magic Car Wash from only $299 at participating locations. Magic Wash Club is Murph. Thank you, producer Courtney.
Cleaner, safer, and faster.
Beautifully done. He's like Uncle Doug on World of Sport. Now, and there's more. You get the Melbourne bit of tinnies, courtesy of CUB. They can stay on ice until you roll the D's.
Yep, very nice. Certainly will.
And you get, thanks to Cheeky Monkey Coffee Paradise down there on Swan Street, there on board you get the mug, and you also get a nice coffee hamper down there, and Sal will sort you out.
Perfect.
So, mate, you go away with a nice loot.
Well done, Mark.
Got a great little package here. Thanks very much.
Good on you, mate. Well, there we go, mate. I'm just basking in the glory of my beautiful contested grab with the glove on and my precision skills. Every dog has his day.
He does, mate. You're fantastic today. I've got to give it to you. I think I turtlenecked that again for the second week in a row. So the boots are going to be hung up for me.
All right. Can we get to the bottom of this haircut debate? Because call me a Diplodocus, the big lanky dinosaur, but I don't know about Maxi Gorn's hair. I've got no problem with expressing yourself, and I think the players should do it, but it adds pressure to his performance, surely.
Well, we got to the bottom of it today, I think, with Murph. You're a Diplodoke chit. you have no idea, mate. You're old, you're a dinosaur. As he said, he had that haircut in 2005. The boys now, they can do what they want. I love the new blonde hairs, as long as they back it up.
So footy's changed? The game's changed?
The game's changed.
How loose can we go?
As loose as you want.
Pink hair?
As long as you can back it up, you can do anything.
Face tattoos?
If you're into it.
Righto. Well, your challenge for week 8 is go and find us the Dennis Rodman of the AFL so we can hear from an eccentric and I can be put in my place once and for all.
We'll find him.
That'll be week 8. Lance Whitnall, teams on 10.
Murph, fantastic to have you on Channel 10 now. Fantastic to have you on Channel 10, mate. Now, look, this happens every week now.
Oh, Mitch! Again! Again, the glove!
It's embarrassing for me because that's the second week. I think I might have turtlenecked it again. So, well and truly, the boots are up.
Not sure he'd be happy with all the TikToks, Insta stories. Some horrendous stuff out there at the moment. But it's good viewing, but that sort of stuff didn't fly with Pago.
Steve Drury.
Stephen Drury.
I think he was number 5. Sorry, we'll pick that up. I worry a bit about Gorney backing up the old Wacko Jacko mohawk look. But am I a Stegosaurus Rex?
You were saying that, mate. You're a Stegosaurus. You're old. You need to move on. I love the modern
day
player.
Stegosaurus Rex.
I love your hair, Cal. Used to roll that back in 2006. So,
but in the showers, jocks on or jocks off?
Well, you can't. You don't shower with your jocks off. Surely, do you?
No, you don't.
Oh.
Well, you said jocks off.
Don't touch me.
You shower.